Let's get the obvious out of the way. As you can clearly tell, I am American. Moved to London from Texas about 3 years ago, mostly because I just couldn't stand the gun violence. Live in Lewisham now because I love knife crime. Honestly, if you're used to gun violence, knife crime's just wang. Guy jumps out at you from the bushes wearing a balaclava and a powdered wig. Stand in the living old coin purse, good madam, lest I be forced to cut you from chicken gizzard to pleasure pivot with yon switching blade. Now, 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 don't be cheeseburying me. I want to see every last falling and harpening. Oh, I love a good old-fashioned artisanal mugging. Been a culture shock too, coming. I mean, like, until I went into my first corner store, I swear to you, I did not know that crumpets were real. I thought they were a fairy tale food. You know, like what a princess would feed to a unicorn at a tea party. I mean, I had to have them, so I took them up to the counter. Guy says it's £2, and I ask what I think is the most natural question in the world. How many pounds are in a quid? Without missing a beat, he told me it was 10 pounds to the quid. Yeah, I got ripped off. That's why I shop at Aldi now. There, it's only 7 pounds to the quid. Yeah, another thing I don't get is this whole British class system. Like, someone tried to explain it to me. They said, well, because you're a programmer, that makes you part of the technical middle class. And I was like, I don't understand what that means. I guess it means that I can technically afford to shop at Waitrose. But I don't technically got the breeding to shop at Waitrose. Yeah, and the biggest thing I had to get used to is winters in London, because we don't really have those in Texas. We got the normal seasons: spring, summer, and summerer. My seasonal depression last winter got so bad, I mean, I barely had the energy or the motivation to even hang up the Christmas noose. I'm kidding. I don't even know how to tie a noose. I'd have to use a clip-on noose. You know, like the kind they make for little kids. I did try to Google it, but when you type how to tie a noose into Google, it just spits back the number for the Samaritans. And they don't know either. By that time, I was getting targeted ads for rat poison. Microsoft's Clippy popped up. Hey, it looks like you're going to write a suicide note. Would you like to use one of our many templates? My mental health, though, has gotten a lot better since I came out as a trans woman. Thank you. I do appreciate that. And it really helps that I do have the support of my family, at least as far as it goes being a trans woman. I don't know how they're going to react when I tell them I'm a lesbian. I can just hear my dad now. No one in this family is going to get a vagina installed unless they intend to put tons of cock in it like the good Lord intended. I just want to leave you with a couple things. First of all, I don't know what triggered this change in me. Well, not really a change, just a realization. I remember a bunch of little things. Like, I had this crush on this lady. And I remember thinking to myself, man, I would cut both my balls off just to see her smile. And then I thought, wait a minute. Why is that plan A? Most men will start with flowers. Even Van Gogh knew to stop at the ear. I'd be happy to answer any questions that I have the answers to. Just don't ask about the genitals. I mean, trans person's genitals kind of don't exist except in a quantum state between you shouldn't know and you shouldn't care. And that waveform does not collapse unless you observe or interact with them. It's the theory of genital relativity. Honestly, asking a trans person about their genitals is kind of like asking the queen about her genitals. You don't really gotta know whether the queen's got a tickle gizzard or a pleasure pivot. Unless, you know, you're the one in charge of the Jubilee Vajazzling. I thought about getting a Vajazzling myself, but then I thought, nah, pretty nuts, right? Anyway, on that groan, I'll leave you. I'm glad I hope you had as much fun coming out tonight as much as I did.